So excited. Right now we got Hilary. Let's do this.
You have two people standing here before you, scared to death because they're starting a new journey, stepping out in faith to life and love committed together. You're here because your family, your friends, your love has supported them, and they need that today. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
They're awake. Father, you have made the bond of marriage a holy mystery, the symbol of Christ's love for his church. Hear our prayers today for Hilary and CJ, with faith in you and in each other. They pledge their love today. May their lives always bear witness to the power and the reality of that love. We ask our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son and our brother, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the scripture reading. Secondly, you need to say yes to the other. Because CJ, you're in the same place she is. And Hilary, same place CJ is. Both strengths and weaknesses. See the whole part, the whole package, and say yes to it with deep and profound love. The third yes, I need to introduce a question. The Lord tells us in Scripture that wherever two or three are gathered, am there in their midst. Why? We never apply that to families. Why is that not our central vision of what marriage is? We're two or three are gathered in my name, I am there. What I'm suggesting is the third yes is a yes to that presence of God in our lives. The God who is love. The God who knows us better than we know ourselves. There is a short verse from the hymn, Thy Love. The love I feel today, my Lord, is only a shadow of the love which you have for me. If you're willing to say yes to the Lord's presence in your lives, that will make all the difference in the world. God is not a person. He offers a gift that we have to accept. And now I invite you to come together here before this altar so you might offer an exchange for a gift. You've come together here in St. Thomas Church so the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in his presence, in the presence of your family and your friends. Christ has already abundantly blessed your love. He consecrated you both in baptism, and now he enriches you with a special sacrament that you may assume the duties of marriage in a mutual and lasting fidelity together. I ask you to state your intentions publicly and clearly. Hilary, CJ, if you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage.
We have.
Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives?
We will.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
We will.
Tina, good of you to stand. Wayne and Patty, please stand. I, Christopher.
I, Christopher.
Take you, Hilary.
Take you, Hilary.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Hilary.
I, Hilary.
Take you, Christopher.
Take you, Christopher.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
You declared your vows before the Lord and his people. May the Lord his goodness strengthen your love and your consent and fill you both with his richest blessings. That God has joined together, let no one divide.
Hilary, take this ring
as a sign of my love,
as a sign of my love
and my fidelity.
And my fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
CJ, take this ring
as a sign of my love,
as a sign of my love
and my fidelity.
In the name of the Father,
and of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Would you please stand?
Lord Jesus, you build up the faith of your pilgrim church here on earth. Continue to guide each of us on our life's journey. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own personal intention and prayers that we remember now in the silence of our own hearts.
My sisters, my brothers, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be something
to God and sacrifice at your hands. The praise and glory of his name, for our great good of all his church.
Receive, O Lord, the offering today of the security, the sealing of the sacred bond of marriage. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, if you have forged the covenant of marriage as the sweet yoke of harmony and the unbreakable bond of peace, so that the fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, the rebirth of baptism also increases and grows your church.
Let us turn to the Lord and pray that he will bless with his grace this woman, Hilary Ann, now married in Christ to this man, Christopher John, and that through the sacrament of the body and blood of Christ, he will unite in love the couple he has joined in his holy bond. Join your hands. Father, by your power, you have made everything out of nothing. In the beginning, you created the universe and made mankind in your own likeness. You gave man the constant help of woman, so that man and woman should no longer be two, but one flesh. And you teach us that what you have united may never be divided. Father, you have made the union of man and wife so holy a mystery that it symbolizes the marriage of Christ and his church. Father, by your plan, man and woman are united, and married life has been established as the one blessing that was not forfeited by original sin or washed away in the flood. Look with love upon this woman, your daughter, now joined to her husband in marriage. She asks your blessing. Give her the grace of love and peace. May she always follow the example of the holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband put his trust in her and recognize that she is his equal and the heir with him through the life of grace. May he always honor her and love her as Christ loves his bride, the church. Father, keep them always true to your commandments. Keep them faithful in marriage and let them be living examples of Christian life. Give them the strength which comes from the gospel, so that they may be witnesses of Christ to others. Bless them with children, and help them to be good parents. May they live to see their children's children, and after a happy old age, grant them fullness of life with the saints in the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not upon our sins, but upon the faith of your church. And grant us the peace and the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen. With your spirit.
And share with one another a sign of the Lord's peace. sharing the one bread, one cup. So now, make them one in love with each other forever. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Capuchin Franciscan would like to use the blessing of St. Francis to close. Hilary C.J., friends, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May he turn his face to you and have mercy upon you. May he show his countenance to you and fill your lives, your hearts, your home, your families with his peace. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Christopher Connect.